Okay, so I'm going to show you guys how to do a four-step walk cycle. Here I have a little example here for my little Barmali character. It will just be pretty simple. The walk cycle can be a little bit more elaborate. If you notice, like, his legs don't bend and there isn't that much intermediate movements. They're just four basic movements that he performs. And then the rest is just moving the head and stuff like that. And I'm also going to show you how to have the character. You can have him walk in place. So he's not moving. He's just walking in the same spot. And then you can have a background move, which is, you know, that's pretty simple. But there are times sometimes when you may want to actually move the character, like, you know, across the screen. I'll show you how to do that as well. So this is a little example of, you know, what it looks like. All right. So let's get into it. So first, here I have the symbol for the character. I actually have two little schematic diagrams here so you see how the cycle looks. I double clicked on the character, so now I'm inside the symbol. Okay, now I should make a note of this. I'm actually going to create the walk cycle within the symbol, okay, and then I'm going to just have the animation occur on the scene, on the opening scene. So basically, it's like embedding the animation in the symbol. Okay, you can do it either way. I could actually break this symbol apart into, say for example, break apart. See, and there it is. And then I can just, you know, animate each part, but I would need to also select all the symbols and then distribute them to layers. See, right click, distribute to layers. And then I would be able to do the same thing that I'm about to do right now. All right, so I just pretty much undid that. Now I'm gonna double click on this. Now I'm inside, all right? So quick thing, I'll show you again. Notice like the leg symbols are just, it's just one symbol. Okay, I didn't make, the legs are, is composed of three symbols just like the arm is, see? The arm has, each arm has the upper arm, lower arm, and the hand. And then you have the upper leg, lower leg, and the foot, okay? See, you have the three individual symbols. I can highlight those symbols and then right click, actually just F8, create a symbol, and just make that, say, right arm. Okay, and now that becomes one symbol. So that's a quick little trick, you know, when you want to make symbols within symbols. So in if you don't want to, you know, individually move all the parts, all the, you know, keep highlighting all three symbols of the arm, you can just make all those be embedded in one symbol. Okay, and that's what I did right here. So I'll just undo that. So that's what I did with the legs, because if you double click on it, then you see each individual symbol, okay? So if I wanted to work with them, I would just right-click on this and break apart, and then that's how I'd have it, all right? So I'm not gonna do that. Just for simplicity's sake, I'm just going to, I'm gonna do it pretty simple. I'm not gonna actually, you know, bend the legs, per se. I'm just gonna move them, all right? Okay, so here I have, this is the standard walk cycle, okay? We have the different parts of the movement, and it's cycled through. The cycle actually ends here, and then this is actually, well, it ends here because it's beginning the cycle all over again. So here, if you notice, they're both, it finishes and starts with the same step, all right? But with the four-step walk cycle, it pretty much simplifies this whole process. And for my cartoons, this is one I use, because when you want to have your animation be a little more realistic, this is the one you should use, all right? For mine, the four step is pretty much, you know, enough for me. Because you want it to look funny, and you want it to look a little, you know, cartoony or awkward looking. So it's, you know, it's fun to use this type, all right? Now with this one, if you notice, the main steps that they use are this one, and this one. So pretty much when the legs are open, and when the one leg is lifted to swing past the other one, right? One is stationary and one is swinging by, right? So this is what I'm going to do. Now with mine, I'm not going to bend the legs, as you see here, and I could easily do that by, for example, you know, I could break apart this symbol, command B, and then I'll just easily, you know, select this, and to move them, you use the transform tool, okay? That's the select, this is transform. Transform is Q. And then I would just simply do See, I'd move the pivot to the hip and then swing it back like so, right? And then I'll deselect, and then I'd select the lower leg and foot. I'd move the pivot to the knee, and then I'll do that, right? So that would be this step. And then also I'd put this forward, right? But as I said, I'm not going to bend the legs, but if you wanted to, you know, make it a little more realistic, that's what you would do, okay? Now, for time's sake, that's why I'm doing it pretty simple here. All right, so let's get into it. So first thing I'll do is, it's gonna be four steps, all right? 1, 2, 3, 4. So what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna create the first keyframe at around, say, I'm gonna space them like 3 frames apart. So 1, 2, 3. Then I'm gonna create a keyframe here. So shortcut F6. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna lock the lower layer with this. Actually, now that I've explained this, actually, I'll let it stay there. I was gonna delete that, but I'll let it stay just as a reference. Okay, so the first thing is, this is going to be, at frame 4, is gonna be the first step of the walk cycle, right? The 4-step walk cycle. So pretty much, I'm gonna choose one leg to put at the back and one at the front, right? I'm going to leave frame 1, just like he's just standing. So it's almost like he's standing and then he's about to walk off, right? So he's standing, then this, I'm gonna select on this. See, I'm already using the transform tool. It's when you see these little square boxes around the selection. So I'm gonna move that there. Okay, and notice that the pivot point is at the hip, okay? And that's what you want. So if yours is not there, you should put it there. And then there you go. And that's it. So that's the first step. See that? I'm just animating the legs right now. I'm not even worried about the hands or the arms, right? And notice, as I said, if you wanted to, you know, bend the legs like so it would be more like this, then I would just break this symbol apart and then you'd see the individual parts that this leg is made of instead of just one symbol. But I'm just gonna keep it as one symbol for simplicity's sake and staying true, you know, that's the style that I use. So so that's one step. Next step, next 3 frames. Let's create a keyframe. And notice I also create keyframes for all the layers because eventually, you know, you may animate different parts of the body as well, all right? So the second step is, see, the right leg is back. Now the right leg is lifted. Now in this case, it's pretty simple to do that because I'm not bending the leg. So pretty much all I have to do is just swing it forward like so. All right, and that's it. But as I said, if I wanted to emulate this, I would just bend the leg. It's pretty simple. So I'm gonna create the next one. Highlight all the layers. Same frame in all the layers and hit F6, which is to create a keyframe, or you can just right click create keyframe, right? And then we're at step 3, which is the right foot now goes forward and the left foot goes back. And then the final step, 1, 2, 3, and I'm spacing them 3 frames apart. Create a keyframe. And then now the left leg is being brought forward. But as I said, because of, you know, the style I'm using, it's pretty simple. I'm not bending the legs. So it's just like that. And that's it. So the first one is basically the left foot is stepping off, right? Then they're crossing. Spaced out again, and that's it. I'll play it, and that's it. See, it's pretty simple. So, you know, basically, this is really like a very condensed version of the walk cycle, which is pretty useful if you're just doing, you know, a little fun stuff. You don't have to do anything too complicated like bending the legs and stuff like that. It just makes it fun, all right? Especially if you're using a character that has like really short legs and, you know, he won't be bending his legs, it's even better for you, you know? because it gives it this really funny cartoony appearance. So now my walk cycle is completed, right? And it takes a total of 10, 11, 12, 13 frames, right? So another thing is, now, how do I animate the upper body? So for example, I want the head to, you know, like bobble or dip a little bit while he's walking. It's pretty simple. So what do you do is you just alternate. So say for example, when he takes a step, his head goes down because, you know, your body is really lower when you're stepping off, like here, okay? And you stand a little higher whenever you're lifting a leg. So I'm going to say, for example, at here and here, I'm going to lower his head, right? So that would be at the first one. I just select his head and just move it down a little bit. You can use arrow keys. 1, 2. The same thing with here. 1, 2. Or if you don't want to, you know, do the, you can, if you don't want to make the change again, you can just see, it's how it looks. Or you can just copy the frame by holding down option and slide it across, and it copies it. So that way you know that you're making identical, you know, changes to it. All right. And then you may want to, you know, say for example, rock his head a little bit. Maybe you want to rock it forward, and then you just copy that frame to the next two keyframes over. All right. So there you go. All right. And then you may want to move his torso. So for example, you know, which is like, I think an animation principle called overlapping. Now, whenever like the head goes down, you'd have the torso go up, right? So in this case, you could highlight, for example, we're gonna make at this keyframe, his head is gonna go down, his shoulders and torso is gonna go up, and it's gonna happen here again, all right? And that's how you have the whole body moving while he's walking. So that's gonna happen here, and it's gonna happen here, all right? So you highlight the torso and the arms. See, notice that everything is highlighted. And whenever you want to highlight just as part of the body without having the rest of it highlighted as well, you just lock the layers you don't want highlighted. So for example, I'm going to leave the arms, lock the leg. See, you notice that it's deselected whenever I lock it. See, when I unlock the head, now it's selected. I lock it, it's deselected, right? Look for the other leg, lock it, the lower torso, or the hip, I call it, lock it. Now, only these parts are selected. So I'm just going to use arrow keys and slide them up a little bit. There you go. And then I'm going to copy the same changes on the other side. So I highlight the layers. See that? Hold on option and slide it across. And there it is. It's copied. I'm going to do the same thing for the hip, for the torso. See, it's selected. Whatever changes I make, I'm going to copy it to the next two keyframes. There you go. I'm going to do the same thing for the right arm. Hold on option. And once you start moving, you see that plus sign. It means that you're making a copy. See? So I'm making a copy right here. Drop it. Oh. Actually, I moved it and didn't copy it. So I'm going to copy it. There you go. All right? So let's see how it looks. See that? So now that walk cycle is complete. And that's it. So first step, he steps off, legs cross, steps off with the other foot. See, first right, left foot forward, brings the right foot together, then right foot forward, then brings the feet together, and then it's going to repeat, go back to the first frame, and then it's going to repeat that, all right? And then also, now that you've had the legs animated, you have the head animated, head is going to bop as he walks, the torso is going to go up, and the shoulder is going to go up. Now you can actually do the arm swing. I usually don't have the arm swinging, you know, give it a really weird looking kind of an animation. You could actually have, see, like for example, remember the arms swing counter to the legs. So when the left leg here is forward, now you'd have the right arm swinging forward. I'm just going to swing it just a little bit. See, I move the pivot to the top to the shoulder, and now I'm going to swing it forward a little bit. See that? Now I'm going to select the left arm, move the pivot to the shoulder, and then just swing it back. Actually, see, selected the torso with it. There you go. And you just swing it back a little bit. There you go. All right? I'm going to copy that change over. There you go. I'm going to copy that change over right there. Right? So it looks like this. Right? Whole idea is to make him look funny when he's walking, right? So now the walk cycle is complete. I go to scene, and now actually I'm going to, whenever, a quick trick. Now I'm going to hide the schematic diagram, all right? So whenever you wanna hide something, you go to the eye right here in the layer, and you click on it, and then it disappears, right? But if I wanted to also, even though I have it, the X here, I've hidden it, whenever I play the animation, it will be visible. If I want it to be invisible in the animation but still appear on the layer, I double click on this, layer options, and I select guide. By making it a guide, it will not appear in the animation, all right? And you go okay, and I'm going back to the scene. Now, actually, I'll double click back into it so you see something. Now, the whole walk cycle took 10, 11, 12, 13 frames, okay? Now, oh, you know what? I'm going to show you something I did really quickly. I'm going to unlock the head layer. Now, within the head layer, I have, I've created an expression at frame 5. So I'm going to change his face expression by clicking on the head symbol and going to properties, looping, frame 5. You see his expression changes. Frame 1 goes back, frame 5. Expression changes, all right? And I click and I select single frame, so that means it won't loop to, you know, it won't change to frame 1 and go back to frame 5. We'll just stay at frame 5, all right? So it took 13 frames. So now I go back to the scene. If I want to see that animation, so I'm going to hit enter. Nothing plays. I have to give it 13 frames at least for that animation to take place, all right? So I hit F5 to create frames, and now, see, he walks through it. But what I'm going to do also is select on this. If I hit single frame, nothing will happen. See that? So for example, if you want him to not walk at all until a certain point, then you would move this for, okay, I'll show you a simple example. Like you could select this, and then move it to wherever you want. Wherever you move this to, that's where the animation will begin, okay? So if I highlighted all these frames, and then I move it here, the animation won't begin until at this point, okay? So basically, you could have something else going on, and then, boom, he starts walking. Or, I'll show you another example, actually. I'll put that back. You could have this, the guy just stand there, and this would be, say, single frame. Then you create a keyframe. Say for example, let's give it 60 frames, right? And you wanted him to start walking at frame 20. Simple. You create a keyframe, F6, and then here you select the symbol, then go to properties, and then select play once. So I'll show you what would happen. Nothing happens, start walking. See that? And notice he stops walking because I hit play once. Now, if I loop, he will keep walking until the frames are complete. I'm going to hit loop. Nothing, keeps walking. See that? So, as I said, because at this point I clicked on the character, and actually, notice you have single frame 1. I could actually have him begin walking at any frame that I want within the walk cycle. So, for example, I want him to begin walking at this frame where he steps off, and which is frame 1, 2, 3, 4. I could go back to scene, and at this point, see, there's no walking here. Single frame, loop. Okay? So at this frame, I click on it, loop, and then select frame 3 or frame 4. See that? Now he's going to start walking. It's almost like he steps off. So there he is standing, starts walking. See that? And that's how you have him. So I'll just remove that keyframe. Select, I'm using Shift F6. See that? Now he's not walking at all, okay? To make him walk, I hit, select him, and then hit loop. And now he'll walk. See that? Now, how do I make him? Now, this is when you, if you want, if you say, for example, he's walking down the street, then you would just like, you know, use another layer, create a background, and then just basically move it in that direction, and it will seem like he's walking forward. Okay, that's it. If you want to just have him walk in place. Now, if you want to have him walk from, say, for example, from one side of the screen to the other side. Okay, actually, let me just play this animation now. See, that's what happens. Now he's walking pretty quickly in space, and he's pretty mad about something. All right. Now, if I wanted him to walk from one scene, one side to the other, now all I do is select this symbol. Say I bring it there. Create a keyframe somewhere here. Right? Now I move him across. By holding down shift, I make sure he's moving horizontally. Move him right off the screen. Then I'm going to create a classic tween or motion tween. Now what's going to happen is he walks across. And that's how you do it. So let's play the movie. That's how it looks. See, notice how he's walking pretty quickly? And he seems to be staying in place. Actually, I'll do that by moving these frames. Yeah, so now, see that? He walks off the screen. Now, he seems to be walking pretty quickly. If you want to slow him down, you just create more frames here. So you simply move the slider to any area between here and just hit F5. And that will create frames. And by creating more frames, you're creating more time. So in other words, it takes more time for him to move from one side to the other, and it appears as if he's moving slower, okay? So this is how you do it. See that? Now he seems to be walking a lot slower. You want to pick up the space a bit? Just do like so, remove those frames. And now he's going to be moving pretty quickly. All right? So that's how you do it. It's pretty simple. As I said, you can use the 4 steps walk cycle. You know, if you're doing little simple cartoons, because it just makes it look a lot funnier. You know, it's like you don't want it to be too realistic. And if you want him to say, for example, raise his hand up, you would just go in and just, you know, make whatever changes you want. So he could be like, you know, moving his arms up and down while he's walking. And that's how you do it. There you go. Simple 4-step walk cycle.